Good day everyone, this is Jason Santos, your practical research teacher, and for today, we are going to answer a question from one of our subscribers. So, good afternoon, I am a grade 11 STEM student, and pwede po ba magtanong ng mga suggested topic ideas niya po for my research? Thank you. So, I find this an interesting topic to discuss, although I have already given my inputs on how you should create your research title in the past, ano? And if you would recall, research title, of course, would be based from your track of specialization. Ngayon, when I talk to the student, ano, since na-mention niya na siya ay STEM, I did not give a topic right away, but rather I ask her leading questions, and from there, nakabuo kami ng title na pwede niyang gawin, ano? So, I'm going to share that conversation with you. Baka makatulong siya sa inyo in your plans to create your own research title. So, sabi ko sa kanya, anong topic of interest mo sa STEM? And then, let's try to come up with the title based from your interest. Sabi niya, ngayon I'm interested with science and technology kasi po ang daming problems sa society related dyan. Ngayon, science and technology is too broad, no? Medyo malawak pa yun. We have to be more specific, and I've asked her if there's any field within science and technology na gusto niyang i-explore. And maganda na na-mention niya na she wanted to solve problems sa society, which is, I like that, ano? Kasi after all, researches are made to solve problems, no? Or to provide solutions, to answer questions. So sabi niya, malapit kami sa Taal Volcano, madalas po ay nagbubunga ito ng sulfur. Interested din ako sa topic na yan. And that is a good topic na sinuggest niya. No? Okay, very good. Since malapit ka sa Taal, sa tingin mo ba mas maraming good or harmful effects ng sulfur? And then nag-mention siya about election. Although sinabi ko sa kanya, much better na yung sulfur na lang for Taal versus yung election, kasi yung election topic, this is more of a humanities or general academics na topic, no? Sayang naman kasi science student siya, no? So mas maganda kung related to science ang aming magiging research. So going back to the question, mas marami ang harmful effects. Okay. Now, bakit ko tinanong yun, ano? Itinanong natin siya kung bakit, kung alin ang mas marami, whether good or harmful effects. Because knowing which is the more common topic, okay, already eliminates that from the possibility of it being researched, ano? Kasi ang tawag natin dyan, common knowledge, no? Common knowledge na ang sulfur ay mas maraming harmful effects. Okay, if it's common knowledge, then hindi ko naman sinasabi na wag niyo nang i-research, no, but rather it's going to be a little more challenging and difficult to have that presented in a panel and have it approved, moreover. So dahil alam natin na mas maraming harmful effects ang sulfur sa biology, living organisms, no, within that area. Tinanong ko siya, do you think meron din bang mga good effects ng sulfur? No? Kasi hindi naman lingid sa kaalaman natin, may mga products din na napoproduce out of sulfur. And one example of that is yung popular na sulfur soap. The sulfur soap is being used to treat skin problems like acne, so on and so forth. No? So, because of that question, nag-search siya sa internet and meron din daw mga good effects. So, that's good, ano? At least, nag-re-research na siya on her own. So, madalas gamitin ng mga kabataan yan for acne, facial cleansing. Thank you, laking tulong. Thank you sa idea. And hindi ko pa nga siya nabibigyan ng title, no? I just given her ideas. So, ito, finally, I have given her a title. No? Pwede ka mag-come up ng research title about perceived good effects of sulfur by the residents of Taal, Batangas. Kasi harmful effects, it's already common knowledge. Ngayon, what we wanted to gauge here is that Sa tingin mo ba, alam ng mga taga Taal, Batangas na may mga good effects ang sulfur? Okay? If there are, kasi there are only two possible outcomes here. Hindi nila alam or alam nila. Okay? We will know the perception of Taal residents if there are good effects of sulfur. Since nakita naman natin na yes, anong pwedeng gawin ng community to harness this natural resource? So may problem, gagawa natin ng, o offera natin ng solution. Kung mapapalabas natin sa study na majority sa kanila, hindi nila alam na may good effects, then it's time that they know. So gagawa natin ng mga information dissemination through the help of the local government. Na hindi lang puro harmful effects meron ng sulfur. After all, this is a natural research natural resource, no. I don't think merong ginawang bagay ang Diyos na walang kwenta, no. Lahat 'yan merong purpose, okay? So, if mapalabas mo naman na alam nila but they are not doing anything, then you can come up with programs sa local government unit ninyo para maturuan ang mga tao paano gamitin ng tama ang sulfur compound. So, if alam nila but they are not doing anything or there are no existing programs, then why is that? So, yun yung mga problems na susolusyonan natin, no, through this research. So, sige po, noted. Maraming salamat. Happy Valentine's. So, see, no? Ganun ang paggawa ng research title. You have to determine first ano yung track mo sa senior high school. And then from that, you ask funneling questions or narrowing questions hanggang sa makarating ka sa pinakang specific na problem or issue na gusto nating ma-resolve. Now with that, I hope I was able to answer questions related to this or sana nakatulong din siya sa inyo sa paggagawa ng title. If you have questions, feel free to send me a message at my Facebook page, Prof. Jason X, or here in my videos in YouTube. Keep supporting the channel by liking, commenting, and subscribing. Thank you so much, and I will see you on the next video.